What will be the most common reaction when I ask, divide the sheet in two? Think for a second. Where to put the line? My guess is that most people go for one of these choices. In the middle. Here are some other options. In life, we tend to like to receive an equal share. So it is socially the right choice to share fairly. But unlike this socially praised behavior, in art it's usually the wrong answer. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. No, it's not a Piet Mondrian artwork. Instead, this one is made by Marlow Moss, a female contemporary of Piet Mondrian. I like her artistic choices, like skipping the black lines. Oh, here, just a few black lines. Here, I notice a white space around the color within the black grid. And when looking a bit longer, I notice this yellow part isn't in the middle of the white space. Or here, parallel lines, which gives me the feeling she divided the painting in two halves, or even maybe three parts, when you count the middle white as a kind of neutral ground. I take a sheet of my usual 50 by 65 cm multipurpose paper and a standard European A4 black one. When moving it, I can look for an interesting composition. Keep in mind, dry swimming like this is free. It doesn't cost any money. What I now do looks perhaps too simple, I know. But playing like this, integrated into your art making process, can be a big win. I, for instance, notice when the black one comes too close to the border or moves too far away to be interesting. Training my senses and learning to trust them is now a natural quality that became a friend for life. Do keep in mind, it's just playing, messing or goofing around. I'm not making anything. Maintaining a playful, joyous mood keeps the door open for new ideas and keeps my controlling mind at ease. And remember, while playing, logical choices like in the middle or in the corner isn't interesting to look at. Let me show option number 4, how to divide a canvas or a sheet into squares. Later on I will even show a fifth option. I prefer to use a second sheet. Without the use of a ruler, I easily can create fairly straight squares. I learned to trust my gut feeling and just as easy check from time to time to see if my inner compass is still right. But because the second sheet blocks my view on a big part of my sheet, I switch to a smaller second piece to finish the job. I now have a million options to continue and this sometimes paralyzes me. So I take a little white paint and fill in just one square. It looks like nothing, and I can always change it later on, but I started. I get my inspiration from these artworks by Marlow Moss. I like how she plays with several versions of white, muted colors or open spaces, so I will use several pieces of paper I currently have at hand. Choosing muted colors or using things available is just as interesting as going for the primary colors, red, blue and yellow. There's no right or wrong. Trust your instinct. Dive into a project like this and have fun. Here you see some process pictures of the participants of my painting course. I brought similar objects and several types of paper for them to play with. And of course, paint in several colors. Later on in the video, I will show you their finished artwork. In the trash can at the venue, some found these shiny party things, which some integrated in their artwork. Marlow Moss was born in 1889, and around 1919 she changed her forename from Marjorie to Marlow and adopted a masculine appearance. At my painting course, the question popped up, why have we never heard of Marlow Moss before? And one of the reasons is we live in the Netherlands and Piet Mondrian was born here and is, even today, very present in our country. Someone producing similar work will not get as much attention here, unless he is also Dutch and named Bart van der Lek, one of Mondrian's contemporaries. A second reason may be her being a woman in those more male-centered days. Personally, I prefer her artwork. I get the idea she is more creative. But it can also be biased, because her artwork looks new and fresh, because I have already seen so many Mondrians. What I love about her artwork is this aspect, 3D. Here she used wooden slats as a 3D line, which takes the painting in a different direction. Here she used rope and also layering, and by lifting in a way the surface, by adding rope or slats on top of it, she then also was able to move downward. All lines look simple, but are the result of detailed calculations, as you can see here. So here's my Marlow Moss inspired mixed media painting. But I also made a second one, more about it in a minute. Here you see the finished artwork made by the participants of my painting course. I can look for days at the artwork of Marlow Moss or artworks like these, because it keeps my mind in a pleasant way occupied, evaluating all options used. Over to this specific artwork by Marlow Moss. Link up here and in the description below to a video from the Tate Modern Museum in London about it. I get the feeling she plays my mind, creating expectation or lures me into thinking that. I take a new sheet and a thicker 400 grams acrylic sheet. I put some masking tape underneath and start painting, joining them together in a way. By removing this part, my mind still follows the remembered or expected lines, here in red, while also seeing the newly created one. Because I painted the whole sheet and cut away a part of the top sheet, I now have an unpainted part still visible as a non-glossy square. Depending on what angle you look at it, it will be visible or not. A new spot for the cutaway part. A little wood glue, and it is fun to see, I all totally forgot, I cut away a part. a smaller long piece of cardboard and some glue and paint on it to let it blend in. One of the things I admire in Marlow Moss is the use of different materials like rope or metal wire. So I take apart and use an awl to create a hole in the paper. Now it's time for a little color. With almost all things I add, I try to create new lines by deliberately not aligning it with other parts easily already present. And of course, there are a few exceptions, like this yellow part. Can you find the others? An extra layer of white and a part of a skewer to finish it. I hardly used any material. But this one was even more fun to make. Her artwork and this one give me a feeling of space, room to maneuver or places to go. To me it goes way beyond the painting itself. I hope you get what I mean. In case you like to investigate your way of painting in a different way, just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.